today. Today we're going to make Elsa from Frozen.
Great, so we're going to start here with the wire in our polystyrene. I go up and down so that it's loose. Okay, great. So for this video, you're going to want some darker blue, some lighter blue, some flesh color, and finally some blonde hair. We're doing Frozen. It's actually quite cold right now, so I'm enjoying Frozen kind of weather. Great. I've rolled an oblong and I've kept this side clean. Folds and creases to the bottom. Now I'm going to take my blade and I'm going to cut it off at the bottom. Now just one quick note is sometimes when you roll like this a big piece, there might be a bubble inside. So you want to take a wire and really poke through the bottom a few times, just in case you hit an air bubble. The problem with the air bubble is if you finish your figurine, you leave it overnight, that air bubble might expand and then you'll get a huge crack up the side of your figurine. I found this out the hard way. So here's your dress, the bottom half. And I'm going to flare out the bottom part a little bit. There we go. Pinching it out a bit. And I'm going to take my Dresden tool. And see how I narrow just before I get to the hips. Roll this a bit before I get to the hips. There we go. And I'm going to take my Dresden tool and I'm going to cut into it some nice folds. You get like that material kind of look. There we go. And I can pull it some more. I want a long slender also. And then I can slide it on my polystyrene. So the nice thing about this paste is it's going to go hard really quickly, and just for extra support you want all of the weight to rest heavily on the hips. So I'm going to pull it up, burn my wire, and then slide it down again, and I can instantly bond it to the wire. Somebody mentioned in the comments that they used a wooden skewer. That's a very good idea. You can use a wooden skewer. You can use pasta if you like. There's many different ways of doing it. Okay, can you see she's got that hourglass look over there now? So now I'm going to take some of the supers. This one's called Bridal Satin from Rokim. You can have a look there. Bridal Satin from Rokim, and I'm going to take that and I'm going to, in my lid, dust a bit there and then dust on all over. And I'm going to mostly dust it towards the front because the back's going to have a long cape. I'll make sure that it goes everywhere. There's a whole bunch of different luster powders that you can go for from Rokim. Lots of fun. Always playing when I dust. It's like a kid in a candy store with these powders, I swear. Okay, great. So she's dusted the bottom half of her dress. Now we're going to take some of our flesh color and I'm going to add some wholesome on my fingers and I'm going to pummel it a bit And see, I'm folding all my folds to the side so that I get a nice clean part over there. It's my folds at the bottom, and I roll that bit until I get an oblong. And I put that down on my mat and I flatten it. I pat it down, flatten it like that. Now over here, I take some wholesome on my fingers and I start going around, around and around. And I pinch, 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 pinch. What you can do then, because you get a bit of a triangle look, you don't want that, you want a nice angle in between the shoulders and the neck. I'm rolling it. See, it doesn't matter how long you roll it, because you can always cut a bit off. You roll it nice and thin. There we go. We've got that. Now, I'm going to put this down on my mat, and I'm going to push down. And pat this down. Now what I've gotten is I've gotten an angle like that, so that I'm not getting this rounded breast. I'm not getting this rounded chest area, but it's going downward. There we go, a bit more realistic. Now the easy part here is I cut into it with my Dresden tool. With the length of my Dresden tool. And if you go further down this way, you're going to get a bigger bust. If you go closer towards the top, you're going to get a smaller bust. So I've indented my mark and then I start rolling it. Now this time, some people in the beginning, myself included, when you start rolling around here, you get little creases, but with practice that goes away. Especially if you're going to do somebody in a bikini, then it really matters. Otherwise it doesn't matter, you get your creases, you're going to cover it with material anyway. Okay, so I've gotten that part there. Now I'm going to cut off. Now when you cut off, you must be very careful to cut quite close to the middle part of your figurine. You don't want to cut too far down, otherwise you're going to get a bump and then her hips. So you're cutting right here where the torso goes into the hips. See? So I can go into the hips instead of having a bump and then the hips, a double hip. You don't want that. Great. So over here on the side, I'm just rolling it back. You can push and pull this until it looks right for you. Now for the bust, I'm going to go inward on that side and inward on that side. And this I can then smooth down. You don't want to bump in between. There we go. That's how it looks. And you can do it on the bottom as well. Be sure to try and make the bust the same on both sides. You can always push and pull. Okay, now it depends on how much detail you want to put into it. I like to do a bit of the neck and the shoulder blades. And then I'll take my boning tool. Not too much though, you want it to be a little bit more subtle. If you do it too much, then it looks a bit strange. And she looks really hungry. Okay. There we go. So now, this is going to bug me. I might as well just do it straight through. There we go. So now, I can pick it up and put it on my figurine. Right, so here we go. I'm going to slide it onto my figurine. And be very careful when it gets to the neck. Very very, very careful when it gets to the neck that you don't poke it through the side. And I've got that on there nicely. That comes to rolling out some material for her top. And just remember to be confident while you're working, because I always think if you go into a project saying, yes, I can do this, I'm going to do this, you get a better result than saying to yourself, well, I'm going to try, I don't know if I'll get it right. Just be confident. Just say to yourself, yes, I can do this, I'm going to do this, and it's going to come out very awesome. I never get a top order and say to myself, you know, I can't do this. I always go in with a positive attitude, saying, yes, I can. So now we're cutting a little rounded area for where the bust is, and then along. And I cut it down and down. I don't worry about how long it is at the bottom, because that I can always cut away on my figurine. And I smooth down the edges at the top, like that. Great, now here we have her. I'm going to put a bit of water on the front and on the back. Just a tiny bit of water, just so it can clean. And I'm going to put it against the figurine, hold it there, and go around. Now the nice thing about this is it's like covering a cake. You can stretch it all the way around. And you want to be sure to rub underneath the bust so that you don't get any extra folds. And I can turn her around, and on the one side I'll cut down my blade. Make sure your blade is clean. And I don't like this bit of flesh, I'm going to cut it away, it's too much. And on the other side, I'm going to smooth and then cut down again. Once again, you don't have to stress about the back too much, because she does get a cape, but let me just show you. Keep on rubbing, take away this bit of flesh, and you can rub it into each other if you like. You can even go against your figurine and cut this lower. Not necessary, but you can do it. Now, I want to cut this all the way around, and I can see where my bump is. I don't want to cut too high, because then I'm going to expose the flesh. So I'm going to cut just below where the bump is, all the way around. And she's a princess, so it goes down the front. And then once again around. The back. Then you can go and press it against your figurine. Take your Dresden tool and kneaden up the edges. Can't tell you how many of these tools I've snapped. Don't press too hard and snap your tools. And if I find that her waist has gotten a bit bigger, I can make it smaller again. You know how tiny these waists are on the princesses. It's ridiculous. But anyway, there we go. Now I can take my luster powder, my bridal satin, and once again put some all over the front. just as a handy tip. A nice way to clean your brushes is to use some of that liquid. There we go. Okay, great. Now I'm going to take a piece of flesh color. And I've got to make two shoulders. So I'm going to roll a piece, clean part that side again. And then I can put it flat against my mat and round towards the sides and the front. Now if you can think about it, just think about a drain pipe and how it goes round. And then it's, if you had to cut it, it's flat on the one side. So that side's going to go against my figurine. And the rest of it's going to be my shoulder. Now I'll cut that. Here we go. I'm going to wet the side that goes against my figurine. I'm going to place it on to my topper. There we go. And here's a trick that I hope you enjoy. I've got a droplet of water on my Dresden tool, and I'm going to smooth the icing into the torso. And I can wipe away the excess water. And go in there. There we go. And I'm doing it all the way around the back as well. And this is great because you can take your time making a piece and just smooth in the different pieces all together to make something look like it's whole. Great. Done. Repeat the process on the other side. Great, now I've got some of my lighter blue, and I'm going to take a piece, and I'm going to roll, you can roll against your mat as well, and I'm rolling the arm here, so I want to leave a little ball at the end. This is going to go against her hand, so I'm going to flatten it and cut that triangle. Now I'm going to make a elbow. See, I'm cutting into it with my finger at the bottom. That creates that muscle over there, and I repeat the same on the other side, and I get my elbow over there, and then this part I'm going to chop a bit shorter so that it fits in with the rest of my arm. Now she's just missing her hand, so let's make her hand. We've got some flesh color paste here. Now this is really easy. People think that hands are difficult to make, but they're actually really easy. I'm going to roll myself a ball at the end. Now, the smaller the ball, the smaller the hand, so you don't want to roll too big a ball, otherwise she's going to have huge hands. Now place it down I pat it down. Now I'm going to cut the thumb and then over there. So I've taken out the triangle. And I'm going to cut one, two, three. And here's the really important part. This extra, I'm going to cut all the way along and just cut all that extra off. There we go. And I've got a smooth over there. Now's the difficult part. You've got to smooth each finger around so you roll it. Or you can put her fingers together and pat the end. I'm going to roll the wrist again. And here's the magical part. So you take your burning tool. I'm going to take the bigger side. And I'm pressing against my finger. And I'm going to ball towards myself. My fingers curl over a bit. Press her hand. I'm going to cut it off. Finger thumb's too big. Let's make it a bit smaller. Here we go. Now I'm going to flatten that side a bit and I'm going to stick this triangle over her hand. Now let's cut it smaller. There we go. And fold it around the edges. And there we go. There we go. You can always cut into the elbow a little bit, like that. Great. Now I'm going to use some glue and I'm going to stick some glue over there and over there. Oh, I need to cut that shorter. There we go. Stick some glue over there, over there, and against the body. There we go. If I want to accentuate her elbow a bit more, I can always cut into it a bit. There, my Dresden tool. Now repeat the process on this other side. Right, there we go. She's ready. Ready for the next part. Now I just want to say, if you want to add a little bit of glitz to the top of her dress, you can do some water and then dust on some of this one. This is the Crystals Illusions. There we go. Looks really shiny and pretty. There we go. Add some glitz on her dress. Always do it into the cap. You take the powder, you do it into the cap, dust off some of it, and then there we go. Looking sparkly. Now we're going to roll out some of the lighter colored paste, and this is going to be her cape, so we want to roll out quite a bit. The nice thing about this paste is you can roll it out super thin. If you want the recipe to my paste, then just go back to my other tutorial, Introduction to Working with Icing, and it'll give you the recipe as well as the glue, etc. Here we go, rolling out nice and thin. and I'm gonna cut it in a cape-like fashion. There we go. And then cut it at the top. Pull those pieces aside. Pat it down or rub it down in the edges. Just always neaten it up that way. Don't stress too much. I mean, this is material that we're working with. You're gonna have folds and creases and stuff all the way through. Now I pick it up, and if you can see, I pleat it as you would with material, all the way along, holding it together. Let's do that one that way, and then with that, I roll it together with my ruler so it sticks together. I can cut it across and I can put it on. So I've got my cape over here, and I want to put glue not just by her shoulders and her back, but over there and all the way down as well. This is just going to add extra support and it doesn't pull your figurine backwards. Complete it more if I like. And stick. Hold it there. Press it against nice and tight. Add your folds here and there. Love working with material. Doing the material side of the figurines. You can move it around and change it as you like. There we go. Turn it around and I'm going to just shimmy this way and that way. Make it look the way I want. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to take some more blue and I'm going to roll this out long ways this time. Put it down and I'm going to cut around it and then long. Rounded and then long. Bring this into my point again. There we go. Now I've got my two pieces over here. I'm going to use water at the back and I'm going to stick it over and around right to halfway, so I'll make it nice and neat. And poof. And I'll do the same. Round that edge, make it nice and tidy. Cut it where the other one is, so I join them. You can rub them together a bit. There we go. Ta-da! She's got her dress on. Fantastic. Now we can move over to the face. Great, so I'm going to take a piece of my flesh colored icing. We're going to do a face. Now I'm going to pinch off about the size that I want. That's right there. Now I take another little piece of icing, and what I do is I roll my hands with that icing. If you can see the palms of my hands, I roll it away. And that's just to get rid of any fluffies that might be sticking to your hands. And then I can roll a ball. Okay, so now I've got a ball. And I want to roll it so that it's more of an egg shape. You have to think. There we go. Upside down egg. Now I go round, indented. If you look on the side, it goes round. And I go in where the eyes are. Yes, it's looking a bit owl-like at the moment. Don't stress about that. And rub away on the edges to the back. Now I'm going to take my boning tool and I'm going to bone outwards from the nose where the eyes are going to go. And I can keep on pressing it in on the sides to keep shape. Press a bit between her forehead. Here we go. She's got that one raised eyebrow, so we're gonna keep that in mind. So then I've got that so far. Now I'm gonna take my Dresden tool and I'm gonna push this and pull it upwards and push it and pull it upwards and then undercut it over there. I can rub this way at the bottom. And then I've got a nose. Now I'm going to pinch that nose so it's smaller. I can pinch it that way. I can pinch it that way. Now I've got a small nose. And on the sides of the lips over here, you want to go inwards. Just be aware that there by the skin it retreats inwards. And we're going into the chin at the bottom. You can rub her cheeks up if you like. Give her more cheeks. Wish it was that easy in real life, eh? You can even take a boning tool and press in over there and press in on the other side. Now I'm going to take my blade and cut straight across. Now I take my Dresden tool, flat at the top, flat at the bottom. You look on the side. And I'll curl up the lip. And it goes up a bit more on one side. You see her smile? So we can take that up even further over there. Well, she hasn't got very thick lips at the bottom. She's got long, thin lips. Do the nose a bit more. And this tool is quite useful. I got this at a china shop. In the nail section, it's a tiny balling tool, and you can just go in the center over there underneath the nose, and then on the sides. You can even round the nose a bit. There we go. Now the chin, I want to press against my finger and just go round the chin a bit. Just accentuate that she's got a chin there and rub next to it. There, she's got a bit of a chin. Just be aware. There we go. Now, after all of this, my eyes have lost a bit of their shaping. So I'm going to take my boning tool again and go in. Always turn it upside down when I do the other eye. And I'm going to take, if you look at your Dresden tool, it's the perfect shape for eyes. So I'm going to go in on that side, turn it upside down, in on that side and in on that side. And you want to make your eyes bigger. You don't want to make them too small. Otherwise, you're going to have a hard time painting them. And then I'll shape round. Shape round. She's got nice, big, pretty eyes. And this way, you can adjust it. If you see your one eye is lower than the other one, you can just adjust it up or down. So you're happy. There we go. We've got her face. Now we're going to paint it. Okay, there we go. I've got my trusty Noritake palette. It's just so that I don't waste my colors. I keep it on one palette and then use it later. And my favorite, my Arctic Snow. I went through quite a few different whites before I found one that worked for me. And I'll fill in the eyes with white. There we go. Fill in with white. And I'm going to do her lips so long while that dries. Let me take a bit of pink from over here. There we go. And I'm just going to lightly do her lips. You can always add a little bit more white. Bottom lip. More life. It's all about depth. It's all about darker and lighter and creating the depth in between. Here we go. Now I'm going to paint the blue for her eyes. I'm leaving light spots over there. I'm gonna pull in the blue. Now I'm gonna do the other eye. Okay, so now I've got some Cerise and I've got some Enigma. And I'm going to take my Cerise and put that towards the top. Remember to dust it off in the cap first. I blow while I'm working so that it doesn't go too much where it's not supposed to. Then I take my Enigma and do it close to the bottom. Now I'm leaving a little space for where the eyelid is. Gosh, your eyeshadow is heavy. Great. I'm gonna take some black now. And let me just reinforce this pupil. And I'm gonna go around the top. And then make some eyelashes. And I'm gonna take some brown and I'm gonna do her eyebrows. Now these don't have to be perfect. No, this one goes up and down. She's got that. What are you gonna do? I've got ice on my side, look. And then this one's more on the level side. Here we've got some peach. Let's put some peach on the cheeks. She needs rosy cheeks, even if she's freezing cold. Rosy cheeks along the cheekbone. Right, I've clipped my wire to the desired length and I'm going to burn my wire a bit. And place my head on. And you want to do a little bit forward. Now once it's on, you can shape your chin a bit more or your cheeks a bit more. Okay, so generally speaking, I usually leave her ears out, but for information's sake, I'm gonna do the ears for you. I'll take a little piece and basically like a grain of rice and your ears are always there between your eyebrows and your nose. So, let's see if the piece and piece isn't so good. There we go. So I'm going to roll that like a grain of rice. Then I'm going to flatten it on one side. You can see there. And I'll take some water and I'll put some water on the side of the head. And I'll put that against there and a bit behind. Turn that, there's her ear. And I'll smooth that with water into the head. And then, unlike the proper ear, I just go round and in over there. So I'll do that on the other side. Now to get my hair color, I usually, if I'm doing blonde, I'll take some of my skin color and I'll take some yellow and I'll mix those two together. I don't know, I just find that that gives me a nice blonde. So we've mixed the hair in nicely. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take three pieces and roll them. One and two and three. Now I'm going to do the usual plaiting. Press those at the end and the rest over here I'm going to plait. up to you how thick you want to pack this. So there, I've got that. I can stretch it a bit. I can pinch off the top. Now into this, I'm going to take my Dresden tool and I'm going to do some cuts just to show that there's hair there. Okay, so I've got my hair, but I'm going to flatten it on the back over here. And that part I'm going to stick against the back of her head, like such. And then I'm going to curl this over in front of her shoulder. So I've got it stuck at the back, and I've curled it over in front of her shoulder. If you want to make sure that it's going to stick there, add some glue. There we go. Now we add more hair all over. And I usually do this shape that's flattened, and then into that some grooves. And I'll add this all over at the back. Coming towards the front. Can speed up this process a bit. Now here, in between, she's got some loose pieces, so I'm just going to make really, really small pieces, and same thing, just on the tiny side. And I'm going to wet there where it needs to go, and I'm going to stick it over there, but I'm gonna push it in a bit, and then it just flaps forward. See if you can see it goes forward a bit. I'm gonna do two of those. And there is our Frozen figurine.
Yay! So we've made our Elsa. Well done, guys. I'm very proud of you. Please send a picture to my Facebook page if you want. I'd love to see the feedback of how your figurines come out. You can like my tutorial and you can subscribe to my channel. Thumbs up, please. And you can comment below if there's anything that you'd like to know, any kind of feedback. I'd love to hear. So thank you for joining me today. Bye.